Because here you've got Anna, who's probably the most qualified architect in this country. Anna, do you have a master's or do you have a doctorate? She has a master's and a doctorate. I don't think anybody has that qualification. But instead of sitting in a fancy office making the most money for herself, she's working with Mama Ida. So Anna is from the Namibia Housing Action Group, which is a nonprofit which assists the shack dwellers. And her and Heinrich are from that organization. So that organization is what helps shack dwellers do these technical things, water reticulation, doing their own servicing. That's why they can speak to quantity surveyors, do all the kind of technical things that Mayohana was talking about earlier. So she's probably the most qualified architect in the country. But she's holding Mayohana, who is the most qualified person when it comes to working with the grassroots. She has a doctorate in dealing with people. Given to her by the teacher. Then we have Mama Edith. Mama Edith told me 2 years ago, Mama Kasta, she wants to retire. I was laughing in my heart, thinking, where does she want to go to? Such young people wanting to retire. So I'm glad she's still here. I'm glad you left that story that you were trying to tell me the other day. This is another one with the doctorate from the people, for the people. And this is a woman herself who started as a domestic worker who built her way up and not only empowered others with homes, she also has a beautiful home. And Heinrich, I'm always cross with Heinrich. Because one day he even forced me to wear overalls. And he wants to be with the people, but Heinrich is a man who can operate in the boardroom, but he can also operate here in informal settlements. And he can convince municipalities, no, please, we can do our own servicing. No, please, why don't we do it like this? He can, as friendly as he is, he can really push for all of you. So this team here, let me tell you, is at the front line of service delivery, and I'm exceptionally proud to be associated with you for your passion. I'm proud. Look at the demographic diversity here. You have people who speak all languages, who come from every group in this country, working together. What will happen when these people decide they retire? Where are our young people when it comes to this kind of grassroots delivery? So we need to encourage more of our young people to come into these kind of jobs so we can make a difference for our people. But we must also remind each other that when we start politicking amongst each other, it's the people who suffer. If I can say one thing about the shack dwellers as a patron, what I'm proud of, I'm never hearing a tribal story here. They deliver for all parts of the country, and within these informal settlements, there are people who speak all languages. You will never hear a corrupt story of this person wasn't on the list and they appeared out of nowhere. You will never hear a story of money disappearing. So what is the secret sauce here? What is the secret ingredient that is making shack dwellers able to deliver 45,000? And because nobody's taking 4,500, the 10% here. So the reason we trust them and the reason they are able to get sponsors is because we know that the money we give to shack dwellers goes to the people. It's not going to Heinrich's pocket. It's not going to his relatives and to his friends. It's not going to punish those who vote for different political parties than the political party Heinrich belongs to. I don't even know which political party Heinrich belongs to because it doesn't matter. So let us stop politicking when it comes to people's lives. And I want you four to be an example of how to do it. Thank you very much.